Hey guys, I'm going to be showing you an easy way to organize your files. When it came to trying to figure out how to organize all this paperwork, I realized I needed to come to terms with what I really struggled with in my paperwork organization. And I found that I really struggled with three things. I didn't know what to keep, what to toss, and I had no clue how to categorize certain things. So I did a ton of research and I came across Freedom Filer. I also heard some really good things about this company as well. I'm not sponsored by them in any way. But what I found out is that Freedom Filer is a self-cleaning system and it tells you how to file. So you don't even have to worry about it. It totally takes the guesswork out of it. They have pre-labeled labels and on each label is the category that it belongs to. So there's categories like permanent, remove, replace, a monthly category, and they're all color coded. So now let me go ahead and show you some ways that you can implement this system in your files. This system has you thinking a little bit differently. So first, let's go over the monthly category right here. They give you tabs with all the months on them and they separate it by odd year versus even year. And what they encourage you to do is to put all of your bills and monthly statements by the month versus having a separate tab for each one. So for instance, I keep my mortgage, my water bill, my lawn bill, all that kind of stuff in here versus having a separate tab for all those things. And honestly, guys, I love it. Then what they want you to do is at the end of the year or the beginning of the new year, you take out all of your monthly files. You will either put them in the back of your filing cabinet if you have the room or in a separate bin like I do. And then you put the corresponding year back in. Now, once you put all the new files back in, you open them up and any paperwork that you have in there, you toss because you don't need that. This system also makes organizing your tax paperwork super easy. So again, they separate it by the odd year versus the even year. And I have a little purple sticker on here because when the new year comes back, I know to take out that paperwork and then archive it. I have a separate file for those archives and that I keep forever. When it comes to tax, I keep forever. So anything blue or this color sticker, I know I need to archive. Now, what we do is we just simply keep any tax documents that we get in the mail need to go to our accountant. Just goes right in there in its own file. The only thing I have separated out is our medical deductions. So basically just our medical receipts I put in there because we own our own business and we have to keep track of that. And this just makes things a little bit easier on our accountant. Now let's get a little closer and pay attention to all this red we have going on right here. And all this means permanent. You can see it says permanent on top of there. So these are things like your genealogy. Again, it takes the guesswork out with the pre-labels. You don't have to guess what should be permanent. We just did 23andMe, that one in there. This is also things like your health records, investments. Like back here, we even have our vehicle titles. So it all goes in here. I put a little blue dot there because it's something that I don't want to throw away. I want to archive that. So it's like a little archive for that. This is really fun too. You have one for your certificates and IDs. So things like your social security card and your birth certificate. And it comes with these fun little stickers right here, which basically means important. So anytime that there's an emergency, I know to grab any file with this sticker on it. Here we have hurricanes. So if there's ever a hurricane, I know to grab this file out and keep that really safe. Another fun thing that this file comes with or this system comes with are these little alphabet stickers. So M stands for Mike. So these are Mike's medical records. And then this is Stephanie's health records. Now let's go over the remove replace section. And these are things mostly like insurance policies, like your car insurance, your health insurance, dental insurance, and because when you change it, because we tend to change those every 2 to 3 years, you take remove the old policy and you replace it with the new policy. Keeps it simple, and again, it tells you what it should be based on the tabs, which is awesome. Now, one tab I did make up is this tab right here, insurance claims, and I put a little red dot there because we want to keep these permanently, but I wanted to keep them in the section with all the other insurance paperwork. And a tip for you guys is, we did have to make an insurance claim on our half bath due to faulty piping, and I ended up keeping all the paperwork to this claim in a sheet protector, and then I ended up labeling it just to, because I'm a nerd like that, what can I say? But this actually saves space in your files, and I like it because it keeps it all together. Another tip in this category is they have what's called services professionals, and I just keep all of the business cards to the people that work on our house, like our plumbers and our landscapers and things like that. So I know where to go when we need to call them. Now, another thing I want to talk about is in the permanent category, and that is how we categorize our home paperwork, because we kind of put our heads together on this one, and I think it's pretty smart. We just got one of those really big files that you can get and kind of separate it out separately. That's why this one's over here, knowing that everything from here over is home. So this is Harborside, which is the neighborhood that we live in, and we just put all of our home documents in here. Like in here is like our home survey. I do have the remove, replace the home insurance in this category as well, because it has to do with, of course, our home. So that's the only thing I have that's not permanent in here. But I like that it's all together with our home. We have our mortgage paperwork, not our monthly statements, but our actual paperwork. We have our maintenance, so any maintenance we do in the house, our HOA, and etc. Now, the thing I like about this is one day we want to use this house as a rental. So this is kind of getting us in the habit of easy rental paperwork organization. But in general, I do think it's a smart way to kind of organize your mortgage paperwork in general, because I do find myself visiting this section probably more than these sections for reference throughout the year. So knowing that it's all together kind of in its own section is pretty helpful. We also have the resource file. These are neat because this is just resources, so you know what it is. But this is like any travel info that we know. I keep design inspiration and garden inspiration because I'm old school like that. So these are like my little resources. So if you notice, these little documents are kind of like odds and ends, little random things, and not with everyone else. And the reason why is because we honestly never get to these things, but we have to hold on to them. For instance, our warranties, and it says miscellaneous, so any like big ticket receipts go in here. For instance, like my wedding ring, that receipt is in here. And I have this little sticker right here because we need this again in case of a hurricane, so that's helpful. Things miscellaneous, and honestly, this is our jury duty slips. Like every time we get jury duty or had to file a police report because our car got broken into, that's the kind of paperwork I have in here. I don't know where else to put it, but you know, we like never get to it. My education degrees, and this is fun because they have a label for their own filing label. So this is all the Freedom Filer leftover labels and booklet and systems, so they even have a label for that, which is a lot of fun. The files that we have up here are the to-do file, which is under the category active, and honestly, you guys, I don't use this at all. I actually use a bin on the top of my desk because I come to realize if I put any paperwork in here, I'm not going to come back later to do it or to refile it, so I really need to take this file out. The other neat file that they have is greeting cards under the category supplies. I would never thought of organizing my greeting cards this way, but I think it's absolutely brilliant. I love how they have a place for them now, and pretty cool. This is how I organize all my files using the Freedom Filer, but before I let you go, I want to give you guys two tips for really neat and organized looking files. The first tip is pick a file folder that's all the same color. If everything is just all the same color, it just looks consistent and it looks a lot neater. The second tip is to line up all your tabs in a row. This first makes it actually a lot easier for you to find things, and it just looks neater too. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, show me you like it, subscribe for more videos like this. And if you want even more things like this, go to my blog, subscribe to that. I would love to have you there. Until then, I'll see you guys soon in my next video. Bye guys.